In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Permutations. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. For numbers 1 through 4, it tells us to list all possible permutations. And a permutation is essentially listing all the possible outcomes. However, for a permutation, order matters. So 1, 2, 3 is not the same as 3, 2, 1. Those are each different permutations. So number 1, we have 1, 2, 3. Starting with 1 again, we can switch the 3 and 2 so that we have 1, 3, 2. Those are two different possibilities with 1 at the start. Now let's look if we put 2 at the start. If we put 2 at the start, we could have 1 second and 3 last. Or if we had 2 at the start, we could put 3 second and 1 last. And finally, if we put 3 first, we could have 1 second and 2 last. Or we could have 2 second and 1 last. So for number 1, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 permutations. And that's for the numbers 1, 2, and 3. In number 2, we have letters T, V, and W. However, it tells us that we take 2 of those letters at a time. So in number 1, we took all 3 numbers, and in number 2, we're going to only take 2 of the letters. So let's start with T. Putting T first, we'll have T, and then we can take V. Also, if we have T first, we can take W. Let's say we have V first. If we have V first, then we can take T, or if we have V first, then we can take W. And then lastly, we'll look at if we have W first. If we have W first, we can take T second, or if we have W first, we can take V second. TV, VT, WT, TW, VW, and WV, those are the possible permutations in number 2. Also note that once I take a letter, I cannot repeat that letter. So because T is once, I cannot have T, T. I must next pick a different letter. In number 3, it gives us 4 separate symbols, and we're taking 2 of those at a time. So let's start by putting the smiley face first. So if we have the smile first, then we can have the sun second. If we have the smiley face first, we could also have the heart second. Or if we have the smiley face first, we could have the triangle second. Now let's look if we take the sun first. If the sun is first, then we can have the smiley face second. If the sun is first, since we already looked at our option of having the smiley face second, the heart can be second. And then we could have the triangle second. So you can see, looking at this top line, even though I've already had the smiley face and sun, the sun and smiley face is different because it's in a different order. So now I'm going to look at taking the heart first. So when the heart is first, I can either have the smiley face second, or I can have the sun second, or I can have the triangle second. And lastly, I'll look at taking the triangle first. I can have the triangle smile, I can have the triangle sun, or I can have the triangle heart. And again, you can see that I have the heart triangle as one permutation, and then I have triangle heart as another permutation. So even though the same symbols are in each, the order of the symbols matters, therefore they are different permutations. And lastly, for this set of directions, in number 4, I have letters A, B, C, and D, and it doesn't specify how many I take at a time, so I'm going to be taking all 4 each time. So at first, we can have A, B, C, and D. With A first, I can have A, B, then D and C, and then with A first, I can have A and then C second, so then B, D, or A, C, D, B, and lastly, I can have A, D, and then B, C, or A, D, C, B. So you can see that not only does whatever I take first matter, But then I have to take into account once I take second, and then what I take third and fourth. So even though A, B, C, D are the same letters as in A, D, C, B, they're in different orders. Now let's look if I take B first. If I take B first, I can have A, C, and D. If I take B first and A second, like I did above, I'll just switch D and C now. Then I can have C second, so I'll have A, D last, B, C, and then D, A last. And finally, I'll look if I have D second, I can have A, C, or B, D, C, A. Now let's look at when I have C first. I'll look at the times when I have C first, A second, then I'll have B and D. C first, A second, I could also have D and B. Now let's look when I have C first and B second. I can either have A, D next, or C, B, D, A. And then lastly, when I have D second, C, D, A, B, or C, D, B, A. And finally, my permutations for when D is first. D, A, B, C, D, A, C, B, D, B, A, C, or D, B, C, A. And then finally, D first, C second. I can have A, B, D first, C second, B, A. So in number 4, I have 24 different permutations. For numbers 5 through 10, we're going to evaluate each expression. Now the formula we're going to be using is NPR, which says that NPR is equal to N factorial over N minus R factorial. And if you need a refresher on a factorial, let's say you have x factorial, then that's x times x minus 1 times x minus 2, and so on, all the way down until you get to times 2, and then times 1. So writing out number 5, our n is 4, and r is equal to 2. So we'll have 4 factorial over 4 minus 2 factorial. 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And that's going to be over 4 minus 2 factorial, which is 2 factorial. So 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 over 2 factorial, which is 2 times 1. 2 times 1 and 2 times 1 will cancel out. So I'll just have 4 times 3, which is equal to 12. So 12 is my solution in number 5. In number 6, I have 5P1. So that's going to be N is equal to 5 and R is equal to 1. Using our formula, I'll have 5 factorial, N factorial, over 5 minus 1 factorial. So that's 5 factorial over 5 minus 1 is 4, and then that factorial. So that's 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Note the 4s will cancel out, the 3s will cancel out, the 2s will cancel out, and the 1s will cancel out, so I'll have 5 as my solution in number 6. Now in number 7, I'm going to explain how to use the factorial on your calculator. On a TI-83 or 84, or you can even go online and find permutations calculators, but if you're on your TI-84 or 83, you hit math and then go all the way over to PRB, and down to number 2, you will see NPR. Hit enter and then go to the number before that. You'll type in 6 before the NPR, and then afterwards, you'll type in 2. And then you'll hit enter, and it will give you your answer of 30. However, if you do not have the calculator that does that, I'll quickly do out the math. We'll have 6 factorial over 6 minus 2 factorial. So that's 6 factorial over 4 factorial, because 6 minus 2 is 4. That's 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. All the numbers 4 or less will cancel out, so I'll be left with 6 times 5, which equals 30. And that indeed is our answer in number 7. And number 8, feel free to use your calculator, but if not, I'll write it out. N is 6 and R is 6. So we'll have 6 factorial over 6 minus 6 factorial. That's equal to 6 factorial all over 6 minus 6, which is 0 factorial. However, 0 factorial is not 0. 0 factorial is equal to 1. So we'll have 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 1. 6 times 5 is 30, times 4 is 120, times 3 is 360, and then multiplying that by 2 will give us 720, and then times 1 is still 720. So 720 is our solution in number 8. In number 9, we're taking negative 4 and we're going to be adding that to 7p4. And 7p4 equals 7 factorial over 7 minus 4 factorial. So that's 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 7 minus 4, which is 3 factorial, which is 3 times 2 times 1. Canceling out my 3s, my 2s, and my 1s, I'll have 7 times 6 times 5 times 4, which equals 840. But remember, I'm taking negative 4 and adding that to 840, which will give me 836 for number 9. So 836 is my solution. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 10. And number 10, we're multiplying 5 to 6p5. So that's 6 factorial divided by 6 minus 5 factorial. 6 factorial over 1 factorial, since 6 minus 5 is 1. And that's going to be 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 1, which is equal to 720. However, I'm multiplying 720 by 5. So 5 times 720 will equal 3,600. So 3,600 is my solution in number 10. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 11 through 18. And if you haven't done so already, click that like button and subscribe to my channel.